Hey everybody, what's going on? Thank y'all for checking out this video. I really appreciate it. And if you haven't already, make sure you leave a like and subscribe. If you're new to my channel, I'm trying to get to 1,000 subscribers. I'm at 930 right now. So everybody that hasn't subscribed yet, make sure you hit that button. I really appreciate it. It's in the bottom right-hand corner of the video. So it should be like right down here somewhere, just a little bitty red subscribe button. So make sure you hit that if you haven't already. And this video, I'm going over some tackle that I'm getting in preparation for the Lake Wheeler BFL Regional. If you follow my channel, you know, I've actually fished the BFLs for the past 3 or 4 years, but I've actually started to record and video this year, 2021. I made the BFL Regional up at Lake Wheeler through the Bama Division, fishing as a co-angler. So I'm actually, while you're watching this video, the tournament's actually in progress. So hopefully I've had a good first day or a good second day, because I'm fishing for a chance at a brand new Phoenix boat. And if I finish in the top 6 in the tournament, I get to move on to the BFL All-American, a chance to win $50,000. And from there, I can move on to the Toyota Series Championship with another chance at like $35,000. So a lot's on the line this week at Wheeler. I'm actually leaving to head up there on Wednesday. But I'm just going to go over some baits that I got in preparation, kind of what I think is going to be going on up there on the Tennessee River in North Alabama. So I'm going to go ahead and dump this stuff out of the bag. So to begin, the two most important things, obviously I had to get some more fishing line. I got some 15 pound to put on my bait caster, and then 8 pound to use as a leader on my spinning rod. I'm pretty much all the time using 8 pound leader on my spinning rod. I've went to 10 a little bit if it's really muddy water and I can get away with it, but I usually just stick at that 8 pound fluorocarbon leader is what I'm normally using. So one thing that I got, I have a couple, but you know, always gotta have some more. It's impossible to fish a tournament and not get some extra baits. But just that jackhammer chatterbait, I got me two of those. You know, I figure there's gonna be some shad. I mean, in the fall, the shad is basically what those fish are feeding on. You do have a couple that may be super shallow, still eating some brim, or still out there in 18 foot of water out there on a river ledge. But for the most part, the fish are kind of scattered, moving around, chasing those shad, chasing those big gizzard shad, those big threadfin shad. So that's kind of what I'm expecting to happen this week up there at Wheeler. So like I said, I got me two chatterbaits, and then also to go along with that, a little swim jig. I like that that yellow and chartreuse in the skirt. It kind of gives them something that stands out, you know, because I mean they're seeing a million shad the exact same color. So if you get something in there that's just a little bit different, you know, a big fish or a keeper, it may want to try to eat that. That's got some chartreuse, got some flash in the skirt, just a little bit different bait. And then my main thing, of course, y'all know I'm always throwing a fluke. The past month, I've caught some fish on a fluke. Austin and Sam caught some fish on a fluke in their high school tournament, the video that posted earlier this week. But I just got two different styles of fluke, just that regular style fluke here, and then a different style fluke here on this other side. Just, you know, trying to mix it up a little bit with a little D-shad. Just, I haven't actually ever used it, but I'm, you know, like I said, just trying to mix it up. The fish are going to see all kinds of flukes, and anything I can do that's just a little bit different that may get me an extra bite or two could help me, you know, make that All-American or even win a brand new Phoenix boat. So that's the goal, and I'm just going to make sure I got all my bases covered. And then another thing that I think could come into play is if my boater winds up going to the Gunnersville Dam. It's about, I think, like a 15-20 minute run to the Gunnersville Dam. And too, this will go into play on the main lake, but I figure if I'm up there around the dam, around some of that current, I got me two little 4-inch swim baits, you know, same 4-inch, just a little bit different action on both of these. One of them is more of like a streamline, a skinny bait, and this is more of like a little bit more round, circular bait. But I figure I'm gonna throw that on either a regular, just a ball head, swim jig head, or trying to get a little bit sneaky, that little mega bass, that spinner head. I'm not exactly sure what it's called. Oh my bad, it's a little screw head. If you can see that, it's got a little bitty, almost like a torpedo, like the little piece of metal that spins. So that's kind of a little trick. I mean, I know it's been out for a couple years, but I figure if I can get around some finicky fish with that little 1/8 ounce head and a 4-inch swim bait, pair that up, and you know, if we're up there around the dam or around some rock, I can throw that, or even throwing that at a schooling fish or bringing it around some boat docks, just whatever the cover is, that little swim bait could definitely come into play. And then on this one, you know, the same thing. This is more of just your regular ball head. It doesn't have any spinners or any flash on it. And then, you know, same thing, just gonna pair that up, throw it out there to a schooling fish that may come up, fishing in the tail race up at the dam, or just, you know, fishing it out deep, fishing around some boat docks, shallow cover, just whatever may happen. And then, of course, you know, I had to got me some hooks for my flukes. I'm actually got three different sizes. I like to throw a 2-aught and a 3-aught on my fluke. It just depends on if I want it to go a little bit deeper, a little bit farther, I'll put that 3-aught on. But for the most part, I'm throwing a 2-aught. But I actually got a 5-aught hook, and I have a Magnum fluke. It's a 7-inch bait. And I figure up there on the Tennessee River, you know, you got big fish up there. You got some big gizzard shad. I'm hoping if we can get around some fish that may be schooling or running shad, I can put on that big 5-aught hook and that big 7-inch fluke on a bait caster and maybe have a chance to catch a big fish, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pounders. I mean, that would really put me up there in the standings. But like I said, I just wanted to go over the baits that I was getting for Wheeler. Most of it is shad oriented. I've got plenty of crap to use, but I just want to make sure I had all my bases covered. And what I thought I'd be using the most, I wanted to make sure I had some extras and some backups. But what I'm going to do with this BFL tournament, my plan is to make hopefully 5 or 6 videos out of it. That's the goal. So the first one you're seeing, this will be episode 1 of the BFL regional at Wheeler. This is what tackle I'm going to be, you know, the tackle that I've bought. Another video is going to be the travel day, me, you know, loading the truck, traveling up there, getting to the hotel, getting situated. I'll show y'all what I've got tied on for the first day, and then you'll have first day of the tournament, second day of the tournament, and then hopefully if I'm in the top 12 after the first 2 days, I'll have a chance to go out there on Saturday, the championship day, have a chance to make that All-American, win some money, and hopefully win that brand new Phoenix boat. But like I said, just be on the lookout. That should be the next couple videos you see will be based on Lake Wheeler up in North Alabama. So if you haven't already, like I said, make sure you leave a like and subscribe. And if you're new here, if you look up, you know, if you're searching in a month from now, Lake Wheeler BFL Regional, and you see my videos, make sure you leave a like and subscribe. I fish Alabama lakes, Georgia lakes, just, you know, fish all over the southeast. But like I said, thank y'all for checking out this video, and hopefully I can get up there to Wheeler and get on some good fish. Thanks.